Well, we have a short time today. It's going to be much less stressful. And I just wanted to let you know that of all of you that took the time to fill out your exit tickets, Jack and I both have reviewed those. And the whole idea is that we can learn from those comments and the pains that you suffer through and all of that to improve. This is still a work in progress. And, I've taught, Wiki sites, whatever, for a number of times with a number of groups, not just CEEMS, but with all my students at school and all of that. And I'm sure they share the frustration that some of you had in getting through it. So some of the comments in there kind of run a common thread, and that is that the pacing is not always exactly where you are, meaning some of you are faster and you have to wait. Some of you get behind and you feel stressed because you're not keeping up. It's really hard in a group setting to stay exactly at the right tempo. And so one of the things that we thought would be really beneficial as we do this again like next year is to have more assistants. Like if we had one assistant between two of you that was right there that had already done this, then they could be right there to intercede any kind of issue that you might have, and I think it would make everything flow better. So I hope that we've addressed that. If any of you have any other suggestions for improvement, you can email those to either one of us, and we would certainly take, because we go back through this and try to make it, we're trying to make it perfect, so maybe at the end of CEEMS, after 5 years, we'll have it right. So we have taken some notes, and is there any other question that's hanging with you that needs to be addressed before we finish up? I believe everyone was successful. I mean, I checked them all last night. There were two that I didn't get, and then they were finished. They were done. So it was just a matter of the way it was shared with me. So I think we're good. I think you're all really, really good. So for as much as you complained on there, you were successful. So you did a really good job, which means ultimately we did a good job. You just didn't like the way we did it. All right, so so these are the things we're going to do, and I'm quick, right? Go too fast. So we're going to do this quick because Jack's material is really important because it all has to do with the development of these templates and all the work that you're going to be building. So the wiki is just a place for you to put it and share it. And that's important too, once you have that foundation like you already do. What we're doing today is just a little bit of managing your wiki. So how do you delete files if you get them there and you need to delete them? We already told you that if you put up a version of a document, we really don't want you to delete it. We want you to just upload the same file and it'll just create a new version. But if you did want to delete files, and you may want to do that today, you could delete all of those files that are in the Unit 1 folder because those were all just test things that are nothing, right? So you could go through the exercise of deleting those files. How do I download files? We're going to cover that. Can you recover old copies of documents? And that would be your different versions. What happens if you upload a document with the same name? Again, that creates a version. How do I view files? That's important. There's a couple different ways. How do I let my collaborators know that I made changes? We'll talk about that. And how do I change theme colors? And I know that the way we did them yesterday, for the most part, are very bland and generic, and they work well. There's nothing wrong with that. But if you want to be a little flashier, you want to do something a little different, then I'm going to show you that. How do you delete a page? Again, you got to be careful with that one, especially if you've uploaded content. So you don't want to just be deleting things without, checking yourself. And if you want to delete your whole wiki site, when this whole program is over, I would think that we would want you to keep it up there for a while. But once we've gotten all of your material off and it's on the CEEMS website, then probably the wiki is not of any service. But while you're in the program, at least for those 2 years, you need to keep that thing up and active. And where can you get more help? Besides Jack and I, there's some online assistance too. And how do you upgrade my wiki to the 2014 standards? That's for the people that aren't here, okay? I think Beth is back there. There's a couple of people back here. Okay, so let's get going fast. Deleting and downloading files. So on this particular slide, I think I went too fast. Sorry. There we go. So when you look at that list of files on the page, it's going to give you a little icon that kind of tells you what kind of file it is. That's helpful. And then there's two ways. One, if you want to just click on that file, it will launch it, a Word document, it'll launch it in Google Doc. So it'll be like a browser opening of it. And it's really a nice way to just preview things to see what's there. But the formatting of our template was done in Word, Microsoft Word. And so when you do it through the internet, through the browser, it's gonna lose some of that formatting. So if you wanna know the exact look of your template, you have to download it, and that's the arrow over there. So if you click the download, then it'll give you a question about what do you wanna do with it. It'll probably tell you where, well, usually they automatically download into the downloads folder. And so then once it's downloaded in Chrome, you can click on it, lower left-hand corner, and it'll open it in Word now instead of the other way around. So here's an example. So if I click on that, you see the W there, it'll launch it right here. There's another little problem with that. You can see everything the way it is in Google Doc. The problem is it doesn't create a new tab, okay? Meaning that if I want to go back to my Wiki, I have to do this back arrow thing. That's a little problematic. So if you use that to preview, you might get lost away from your Wiki. If you right-click on it, you can open link in a new tab. That's a wise decision. But just so that you know, they're just left-clicking on it will take it the other way. So yeah, that's a good idea. Then you haven't left where you were. Okay? And if you're going to download it, well, if you click the X, what happens? It tells you. That's how you delete. So that's how simple that is. And then if you click the download, you see that it automatically went down there, and you have to wait a few seconds until it's finished. But once it's finished, and if you click on it, it will open it and enable editing, and then you're ready to start entering content. So we want you to edit the Word version. Don't mess around with the Google version. That's just if someone wanted to preview it real quick. Questions on that? Pretty simple. Okay. Recovering old copies. We kind of covered this yesterday, and I don't think we have any with version 2 up there, do we? So we don't have an example to demonstrate, but I think it's pretty easy enough concept to understand. As you upload the same document again, it will replace the one that's there, and it'll have a V2 by it. But V1 is saved on the site. And if you want to see it, you just click on the V2, and it'll show you how many versions you've got saved on your Wiki. Am I doing that right, Jack? Okay. Any questions about the versions? Because you will probably have some different versions as you go through building these. Here's an advantage or a good reason for doing that is you might get into version 2 or 3 and realize that there was some really good stuff in version 1 that you had deleted. You can go back and copy that information or look at that information so you don't lose the trail of the evolution of the project. And when it's all done and you've got your masterpiece, then you can delete them. You know, it doesn't matter. But during the process, it's important. And then to download the version, different versions, again, you just click on them and you can download them if you needed to download another copy to your desktop or something like that. Uploading files of the same name, this is what we're doing, the same thing. Easier to manage, do not change the file name. That's important. Don't put version 2 on your file. Don't name your file version 2. It'll do it itself. So it should make it easier. Viewing files, we kind of talked about that. Two ways, we said downloading, so that's repetition. There's the Google Doc. Preferred way is the document itself. And here's where you can, as a collaborator, your coaches will do this. They'll go to the More tab, and they'll be notified of Wiki changes if they come down and subscribe to your site changes. I think there's another. Yeah. So you can subscribe to individual pages, or you can subscribe to the whole site. And I prefer going to the site. That way I can see everything that's done. It does trigger a lot of emails, but it's pretty easy to sort through those and delete the things that don't. This isn't going to matter to you much unless you're going to be a collaborator with one of your colleagues here. But if you are, you might want to do this. Okay. I would say if you use wikis with your students and you go back to school and try to do some of this, you'll want to make sure you subscribe. That's what I did last night. I opened all of your wikis, I looked at them all, and I subscribed to all of them so that every time you blink your eyebrow, I get a notice. I know what's going on. And I won't do much unless there's something that really needs to be addressed. Changing theme colors, here's where you would do that, and I'm going to demonstrate that for you. It's under Manage Site, and there's a lot of other things you can do under Manage Site too, but themes is a way you can get a different look for your web, because it is a website. You know, you can make it prettier than just the generic. Select the theme you like and click Preview before you say OK. If you like what you see, then you can save it, and you can always go back and change it again, so it's not like it's a permanent thing. One of the things I want to caution you about is there's a lot of different themes that you can pick that are not extremely legible. The fonts that go with it and all of that stuff are in script, or just be careful of that. Make sure it's something that's really easy to view. I have trouble with this with the students I have at school. The girls in my classes, they love that ornate, fancy, and then I can't read it. I'm like, you know. But since I and owner with them, just like I have been with you, I went in and changed their theme. And so I said, sorry, I have to do this. You can change something else, but right now I have to see it. Let me escape out of here and, where was I? It's Google, right? Okay, so now here's my deal here. So you go up here to the gear, and a couple other things I did for you, I forgot to tell you yesterday, but you should, if you make these again under page settings, allow attachments and allowing comments was not checked because by default it is not. And I should have, we should make a note of that, Jack, that I should have told you to do that yesterday. But again, it's under page settings. You don't need to because I did it for you. You don't need to do anything. I did it for you. That way you can put comments, because I put comments at the bottom of your page, said nice job or whatever. And it's just a nice way. And the coaches, I noticed Rob Rappaport. How many of you have Rob as a coach? Okay. He's probably already commented on your wikis because, you know, you invited him and he got, right away got on there. So we want to try to minimize our comments. Because we don't want to flood your wikis, but if there's something very important at the time on that page, we will, some of us prefer to do it that way and others prefer to do private emails. Okay, so it really depends on your coach. But that was those two things that I changed. And then also under this, printing things, there's where you delete the page. I think that may be coming. There's the subscribing. See, I haven't subscribed to myself, so I don't need to do that. It's under Manage Site. Now, this is an important tab, not something that you do often, but I just wanted to show you something about this. If you scroll down, you can see that there's a site storage record. And on this particular limited site that I have so far, 8% of the maximum 100 megabytes of storage that they give you for free is used. Okay, so lots of space left. The documents, the templates that you're using are very small in file size. So the only things that are going to be a little bigger are the PowerPoints. And of course, if you did videos and uploaded the actual video file, it would just kill this. So that's why we're going to YouTube and then just inserting links. But that's where that is. You can copy the site. There's lots of other things you can do, and this is where you delete the site. So don't do that until you're finished with the program. And you can have as many sites as you want. Google doesn't care. So by keeping it active, it's not a big deal. You can unshare, go in there and X out all those people you shared with after this program, you know, and all of that. If you just wanted to keep the material up there, no reason why not. But under themes, colors, fonts, etc., if you click that, that's what we're talking about here. And then, have they changed this?
I think they have.
Looks like they have. So here they are. If you click that down arrow, see where I am right there? It's iceberg by default. If you come down and choose slate, it'll give you a little preview down here. See? And don't like that. Ember. Ember's kind of nice, very easy to read. So let's say I like that, I just do save. And now it actually looks a little more like a website. And if I, did I click save? Yeah. And then if I go back to my John Doe, there it is, and there's the new look. So it doesn't change the content, all it does is change fonts, font color in some cases, backgrounds, and all of that. And you can do some custom theme work in there too. I don't want to get involved in that, but there's very much customization that you can do as well. If you're interested and you're so moved, you know, knock yourself out. And if you're interested and you want me to help you with some of that, I'm more than happy to do that. Okay, so if you have, some people really kind of like artsy stuff, and that's where that is. Okay. Deleting a page, I just demonstrated that. You saw where that was, right? It's under page settings, and you just go down and choose delete page.
Yeah, I think one of the problems that we've got on this slide here is you keep referring to more, and that's an oversight on my part. There's actually a little gear there. So
yeah.
Instead of more,
they changed it to the gear. And there's delete page. And there's the deleting site, which I just referred you to. And then getting help is also on the more, but it's a gear. And let's see, I'll go down here. Sites help. Beginner's guide is a great place to go for help on all about Wiki sites, Google sites. And then here's remodeling for the other class. So
there's some cohort two. How many cohort two folks are here? Is Katie? Okay.
So where was that? Oh, sites help right there. See it? That's under the gear. And then here you are. Help center. You can type in a word that you want to look at. Look up. Say insert. There it says what kind of thing you want to insert. Here's insert a video. There's some other things too that you can do that, but it gives you pretty detailed information. So it's really intuitive. You can do it on your own. We could have, someone even suggested maybe it would be just as well to have this Google site workshop done on your own time, just give you the PowerPoint and let you just build it. And I think that would work. We're actually planning to do a little bit of that methodology with you for the video, because video is so involved and there's so much to do, and try to keep everybody on the same page in a classroom environment, it's just really, really hard. So Jack has started out with video part one, the power of PowerPoint. How many of you have used PowerPoint to make a video before? Great. It's such a powerful tool. And so we'll get into a lot more about that, and I think you're going to find that we're going to help you a lot more with video this year by giving you the right tools to do that. So did I do that fast?
That's pretty good.
That's pretty fast. Okay. So I can get out of this. And Jack, you have a second one up or no? There we go. And then those, how many of you got the invitation for the PowerPoint? Okay. How many of you did not? I know there's a couple. It's the Google Doc PowerPoint. Yeah, I shared it with all the email addresses that Julie gave me in a list. And I actually should have shared it twice. Like most of you gave two, a school and a personal. I added all of those. But you do have to be logged into your Google account before you can see it. And it has to be an associated email address with your Google account. I hope you realize that you can, on a Google account, you can associate multiple email addresses and not just the one that you log in with. So if you didn't get it, send me an email, please. And I'll get it to you.
I just Does anybody know what I mean when I talk about an essential question? What's an essential question? Kind of like your objective. It's the problem you're trying to solve. Would you agree that essential question? How can I generate my unit file so I can start documenting? Is that okay? That's where we're going to start today. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is you're going to do the work here. Okay. So, what we're going to do is we're going to go one step further before I let Andrew take over here. Okay. So by the end of this class, you should be able to begin documenting your first unit. Is that fair? Okay. Now, but in order to do that, what I have to do is I have to understand what you don't know. Because I put these perfect videos out on a website. Remember I told you to watch Getting Started and Part 2. Those are perfect, right? And you really shouldn't need any more help, but you might. Maybe you slept through part of it. So, what I'm going to have Andrew do, he's going to go through the process of developing guiding questions. You know what guiding questions do? What are guiding questions for?
They guide the activity.
Guide the activity, okay. So these are questions you might have about where to start, okay? Now, you might be thinking, well, what's a guiding question? Your students are going to be thinking the same thing, right? They don't know what you're talking about, okay? So we'll just get started here. So I'm going to turn it over to Andrew. And he's going to lead you through this process. And I'm going to document. I just put some things here that, how do I do, these are the kinds of things you might start to ask. So go ahead, Andrew. It's all yours. And we're only going to do this for 5 minutes, because then we want to start answering these questions. Okay?
And our goal is, one more time, to create just the guiding questions.
Right now, we're going to create guiding questions. But what was the essential question? How do I get my files generated? Okay, so my guiding questions are kind of get at the how do I answer that question? Okay, so go ahead, Andrew.
Okay, help me out here, guys. Help me
here. Can you please repeat the essential question?
Sure. How can I generate my unit files so I can get started documenting my first unit?
Where's the first place I go to?
That's a good one.
Where's the first place I go to?
Okay.
Under which file?
Is the first place I go to? Hey, Danny, can you keep time? Give me about 4.5 minutes they got left. Okay, so you give me a 1 minute warning. Okay. How can I generate?
I was reading your essential question.
Oh, okay. Okay.
But I'm also asking.
Okay. Okay. Well, we'll put it down.
Yeah, what is generating?
Okay. What was it? Okay, what was it? I heard another question. Sorry, Andrew.
It's okay. What does generate my files mean?
Okay. It's the problem is the ability to mess it up is related to how skillfully I added error checking, right? So, yes, you can. Okay? But don't worry about it, because you just download another copy of it. So. Okay, how are we doing on time, Denny?
2 more minutes.
2 more minutes? Okay.
4, right?
Gosh, yeah.
How about we start there? I think you've got a good list here. Is it okay if we start there?
Yeah.
Okay. So, and let's give Andrew a round of applause. He did a great job. Here, we got a good list. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. So, I'm going to start at the top here. Where's the first place you go? Okay?
Yeah.
Now, when you generate your files, okay, there's two parts to this. One is you got to come up with an idea. How many of you know what you're going to put in your unit? Anybody know? Okay. So, I would say the first place you go is to the library and find out, look for stuff to put in your units. Okay? You shouldn't really start generating files. You could generate some of your files to document what you've learned as you go along, okay? And then what you're going to do is you're going to open up this unit file generator and start putting down, what are some of the documents I need? You need a unit plan. Do you remember Julie's presentation? What are the kind of documents are there?
Unit plan, activity plan.
Activities, okay. There's lessons and activity. What's the difference between a lesson and an activity?
A lesson has multiple activities.
A lesson has multiple. How many activities per lesson? At least two, okay. How many lessons per unit? At least two, very good. All right, you guys are smart, okay. How can I generate my unit files? You remember all the problems we had yesterday with the unit file generator getting it loaded? If I had given you two instructions, it would have went a lot better. If I had told you that it needs to be on the desktop, that folder, templates 2014, has to be on the desktop. And when I say that, it can't be buried inside of another folder on the desktop. It can't be in your documents folder. It can't be in your music. It has to be on a desktop. So that was instruction number one.
Does it have to be called templates 2014?
It has to be called templates 2014 as well, okay? The other instruction I should have given you is close all of your Word documents. Okay. Yesterday, Julie did a session beforehand where she started looking at the templates. And some of it had templates open. The unit file generator uses those templates to generate your documents. Okay. And that, again, that was my fault. Okay. So, but if I'd given you two more instructions, we'd have had a lot less problem. Okay. So, but I've written that down and I'll correct that next year. Okay. So let's do this. Let's walk through. Let's see if we can try to get at this question right here. How do I generate my unit? How can I generate my unit files? What I'd like you to do is to open up the unit file generator. Now, how did we do that? Where is that at?
Okay.
It should be on your desktop, right? I'm going to save these excellent questions here. Okay, so I'm going to open. I actually have already got it open, but if you look in templates 2014, you've got the unit file generator, and you've got all the templates in there, too. So what do you have to close first?
All Word documents.
All Word documents. So close those down.
All Word documents.
I want you to, just for the safety's sake here, let's close, save them and close them. Okay? Because there may be some unintended consequences if there's some open. And looks like I do not have any open here. Oops. So, yesterday you clicked over here on this example one, that populated the worksheet, but let's walk through an example here. And what I'd like you to do is, you can type along if you'd like, okay, if you got some ideas. The first thing we're going to do after we've entered this information at the top, really, you want to put in your unit name. Now, what's a unit name? Okay. So what's your unit name, Andrew? Do you know what your unit name is yet?
Funny enough, I was thinking about doing projectile motion.
Okay, so we'll leave that in there. That's all right. Okay. Now, you'll actually put in unit one here because you're starting out with unit one. Okay, and you put your name, the date. Now, this date, we're going to use that actually in the file name. Okay, so put your name, your email address. We're going to stick your email address in each of these files too, because then if somebody wants to contact you, they can do that. Okay, so put your email address in there. Now, I know you're probably, maybe you're not quite at this point yet where you can name your lessons, okay? But if somebody wants to throw out a lesson name, just throw one out. What might you do?
When we name it here for this generator, we don't want our fancy name. We want the one that's basically so they know what it's about.
This one right here.
I'm going to call it Holy Water Batman. You know, I don't want that. I would want like Hydrologics idol. I'm talking up at the top.
Oh, this one right here?
Yeah.
That one right there, there's two things that does. That describes what it's about, briefly. And it's also, it goes into the file name. So that will appear in a file name. If you make it this long, your file name will be this long. Okay, so you want to keep that relatively short. Okay. Now, I don't know if you picked up on it or not, but do you see all these little red triangles over here? Okay. Those are help boxes. Okay. So if you look at if you just hold your cursor over that, it'll tell you something about that box. Okay. So that one, it says enter a title. It says do not use symbols such as colon, semicolons, etc. Now, why is that? Musa, do you have a question? You can't get to where I am at. Where's Denny at? Denny, would you take a look there? Okay. So just hovering over these boxes will kind of tell you something about it. Now, why wouldn't I want you to put a semicolon in that name right there?
Because you can't put those in file names.
That's right. Exactly right. Okay. So you want to keep them simple. You can use spaces, that type of thing. Okay?
So somebody give me a I'm gonna pick on the first one. The first lesson could be the introduction to your unit. Okay? So I'm just gonna type introduction. Okay?
Now, okay, so somebody, what might be your second lesson? Okay, so it's a demonstration.
Okay.
We don't know what the demonstration is just yet, but we'll just call it a demonstration.
Demonstration.
Okay. And the third lesson? Pick out a word. Is it Lakeisha? Give me a word.
Student lab.
Student lab, okay. Very good. Okay.
And
I'm going to just put wrap up here for the...
Now, would you do it like that? Maybe not quite like that. But we've got four lessons here. How many activities will we need?
Eight.
At least eight, right? Okay. So now, I'm really done with this page. Okay, let's go here to activities and worksheets. One of the things I didn't tell you, what color cells was I filling in?
Yellow,
okay? We only have to fill in yellow cells, and I say only, okay? We've got to fill in at least eight rows in a condition. Notice the unit plan. See this one at the top here? 100. You always know which one is the unit plan because it's got the double zero in it, okay? And the unit plan is always called unit plan. It's got the projectile motion. So if you look at the name, you can see what it picked up from that first page. Okay? Is anybody asking the question, why do we go to this extreme? Anybody asking themselves that question? Tyler, what?
Well, yeah. Didn't we talk about it yesterday? There's so many CEEMS teachers with so many units and so many lessons. Like, there's got to be one uniform way for us to...
Exactly. The other thing is, when you load these to the wiki stores them in alphabetical order, okay? And what we want is, we want your unit plan at the top, then we want lesson one, followed by all the lesson one activities, lesson two activities, so that we can go from top to bottom, okay? And know who's who, who's related to who, okay? Now, I started with some stuff here, but let's go back, just so that I'm gonna let you tell me what to put in here, okay? So this column is the lesson number. So what number do we start with? Lesson number
one, right? Okay.
And what activity number do we start with? Activity one. Okay. Now, I'm going to suggest to you that probably the first document is probably not going to be a worksheet. Okay. So we'll just leave that blank for right now, okay? What's going to be in this document? Remember, it was an introduction?
Okay, so we'll put introduction. Okay,
now, this file content or descriptor, you'll see in just a little bit, that'll become part of the file name as well.
Okay.
Title can be a little bit longer, because what we're going to do with that, we're going to stick that inside the file. Okay, so that column goes inside the file. This one right here is a critical column because it becomes part of the file name. It's going to be over there. See that right there? Okay. And we've already made sure we didn't put any semicolons or anything in projectile motion name. So if you get a complaint, I do some error checking here. If I see colons, semicolons, underscores, or whatever, I'll tell you, or I try to tell you. I mean, you may not catch everything. Quick question. Is it
Brandy?
Brandy, right, okay. I knew that, but okay.
The school that we're at, they have actual documents that we have to use when we go through our introduction. So when we enter those in here, because it's like four documents that the kids have to fill out for the introduction, will we have to do like lesson one, activity one, worksheet A, like each one has to be entered into that.
Are they worksheets? Are they,
they
if,
are.
If you make them worksheets, all you have to do then is take that document. You could either paste it in, or I'll show you another technique where really all you're after is this file name. You could use what I call a dummy document. Basically, you create the document name, but then you just rename your document, okay, with that name. Okay, does that make is it a PDF file or?
Yeah, they're PDF.
Okay, it's gonna generate a Word document, but you don't have to use the Word document. You can use your PDF document and rename it with this name. Does that make sense? What it does is it maintains the alphabetical order and what I call the hierarchical order. The hierarchy is, remember, unit, lesson one activities, and so on. And that would probably be, is that a starting?
Yeah, it's how, because we do project based on a new tech.
Okay, okay.
So we have like project management forms that they have to fill out.
Okay.
And it's two different ones, like the contract and then the management form.
Okay.
So like, would it be easier if we combine both of those to make it like one big document? I mean, like, mm-hmm. We can do as many documents as we wanted under introduction.
You can do.
Because I'm looking at the worksheet letter, like the labeling of the worksheets.
Let's do this. Let's include two lines. I know you got four documents, but just for the sake of, let's include two lines. We're going to include two worksheets. You might make it four, but I can't type very fast, so we'll just, okay. So they'll be part of lesson one, right? Lesson one. Okay, now every time you create a new activity, it has a new number. Activity numbers are unique and worksheet letters are unique. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is we're still in lesson one, we're in activity two, okay, and I'm gonna give it a worksheet letter of A. And what do you wanna call this? So Brandy, what's your first document called?
Group contract.
What is it, group contract? Okay, so group. Okay, and that again, that becomes part of the file name. And here, this is gonna, what? Give me a descriptor for that. What's a good example of what that you might call that? I can just repeat group contract again.
It's actually called New Tech Group Contract, I think, or something along those lines.
Okay, now I'm gonna do the same thing again. I'm just gonna repeat that. Again, you'd probably wanna put four documents here. Okay, I'm going to put, it's lesson one, it's activity three, worksheet B. What's the name? Actually, let's do this. Let's make this, it's still part of activity two. Okay. What's the second document? Instead of a group contract, what's the second one?
Program management form.
Okay. I'm going to leave the form off. I'll add that here. Okay. Okay, so we've kind of covered that topic right there. Now, you'll see in a little bit what that does. Okay, now let's continue with the projectile motion. We've got one lesson here. How many lessons do we need? I think we spelled out how many. I think we spelled out four lessons. We're not going to go that far. I just want to make sure we go far enough so that you understand how we name these letters and numbers and all that. So I'm ready to start lesson two. Okay. Now, I've started on a new lesson. What's this activity? Actually, we don't restart the numbering. We'll start this with activity three. Okay, we number our activities, except where we've got worksheets involved, we change the numbering on those. Okay, so since this might not be a worksheet, I don't know what this is. What kind of document do we have here? Maybe it's introducing the challenge.
Yeah, it could be information for a teacher to look at to do it.
Okay, you might spell that out in your
hook
unit.
Hook activity.
Okay, so hook activity. And I'm just going to write hook. Okay. And now you can see, so look at the file name over there. You can see what the file names look like. Okay.
And I need a second activity for this lesson. That's going to be four. Is it a worksheet? Is it a worksheet?
Let's say it's a data, it's a sheet they're putting data in or something.
Okay, so I'm going to make that, so what letter would I put there?
That'd be a C.
Okay.
Hook documentation or hook document.
Okay, and this is the...
like their data table that they take stuff down or information.
Okay.
Hook activity data table. Okay.
Just about how we... We're just going to...
Okay.
So now, even though that hook document goes with a hook, it still gets a different activity number. It doesn't keep the same. If it, because I want to show how.
Oh, so what you're saying? Okay. Okay. You made it. That's a very good point. You'd make that three because those go together.
Because those two go
right.
together. Okay.
Right.
Good. I got it.
So whenever you and again, it's because we've got a worksheet here.
A worksheet that goes with.
Right. Right. It goes with that activity. We already used letter A. You should, in this column, you should never have the same letter. It should all be labeled from A to Z, and then
AA,
AB, and so on. Okay? And I think if you watch the video, I said you shouldn't torture your students with that many worksheets, right?
Yeah.
So okay. So
sorry,
go ahead.
If we're looking through someone's stuff and we see a letter at the end, we know that's a worksheet.
You know that's a worksheet.
We do not see a letter.
If you do not see a letter, it's probably the activity doc. It's the activity document. Because what this should do, you should be able to look at those now and decide. With don't look at these. Which ones of those are activities? So it's the A, B, and C. Okay. So this one here, this one, and this one are all activities. Or I'm sorry, worksheets. Sorry. I was saying that wrong. That's my fault. Okay. Okay. So hopefully you're starting to see a pattern here, okay? And what happens is that by doing it this way, they'll sort in alphabetical order. So you've got, you know, you got unit plan, activity one, activity two. It's actually lesson one, lesson two, and so on. So you can look at the numbers. After a while, you know, this will be second nature to you.
But
now,
we're not going to be able to generate this until we've got an idea and sort of an outline ahead
right.
of time before. Because it would be moving things around in there all the
time. Exactly. Okay.
So we don't want to start going in there and just putting stuff in because it's going to get moved out and stuff.
What I'm going to do next week, so we've got another session on Thursday of next week. And what we're going to do is we're going to cover tab 3, which is on renaming files. Because what happens if you have to insert, let's say you got a list of 15 files, and you want to insert one smack dab in the middle. Are you going to rename those by hand? You could, okay? But you got to rename everything after it, okay? So we'll talk more about that rename file. I don't want to bother you with that now, okay? If you think you need something, just put a dummy file in there. Just put a name in there and put spare or something like that. You can do it.
You can delete those out.
You can delete those out. Okay. Karen?
I think this is actually a simple answer, this one, but like I put something in the wrong order. And this doesn't, it's not quite set up like a regular Excel. I don't think I can't flip-flop two rows.
Well,
so I want to flip row 7 with row 6.
The way you, well, let's do this first. One of the things you can do is sort this. If they're not in the right order, you can sort them.
Right.
Really, what you can do is you can just change the lettering or numbering here and then hit sort and it'll sort them in the right order. Okay, so let's say I really wanted this to be 2 and 3. Let's see, let me do that again. So this is Control Z. So I want this one to be 2, 3. And I want this one to be 1, 2. Okay, I'm going to hit sort. Okay. Now my lettering is messed up, so I'm just going to change this to a B.
Gotcha.
And I'm going to change this to a C.
Okay.
So that's what the sort is for, just kind of help you with that issue. Brandy. I want to get back to these excellent questions that Andrew had you guys developed. So, but I am going to generate the files here now. If you're okay, is this okay? Are you okay with this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So how do we generate the files?
Create.
Hit click create.
Make your...
Oh, one of the things, did anybody try the plus here? Or the minus? Okay, so for... Anyhow, so I'm going to click create. And notice here, okay, there's the little word flag. It's generating the files. Okay, and it tells you what files it generated. Just click the done. It's just really just more informational. It tells you what folder did it stick them in. It says it's in the unit archive folder. In this folder right here, there's the date and the time, 1542. Okay. So let's go take a look at what it generated.
Can we generate just a unit plan before we even have any?
Let's see what's here. What I don't know, you know, that's a good question.
So can you try it?
You can try it. You can just try it once. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the desktop.
Okay.
And I'm going to go to the unit archive.
Desktop.
Okay, there's the folder right there at the top. You always have to, sometimes it sorts them in it sorts them in time order, chronological order, it could be. You got to look at it. So there's the okay, so there's the files. Okay, now let's take a look at the difference between the unit plan. So the first, second, and third document all have different formats.
What?
Okay, look at this, see? So we've got the unit plan is a unique document. Okay, I'm going to show you what that is. There's the unit document. See, it says unit right there. Unit archive, and it should be the one that's labeled with today's date and the time that you generated it.
Oh, I didn't save it.
Okay. Now, Julie explained these yesterday, so I'm not going to spend any time explaining these. Okay. But notice what it did do is it put the unit one projectile motion in there. It put my email address. It put the date. Okay. So you don't have to put that information in your documents. It's going to stick it in there for you. Okay. So that's the unit document. The second document was an activity. Okay, there's an activity document. Okay, so again, it puts that header information at the top, and I must have spelled something wrong here. Okay, but you can start to see where stuff starts to end up. Okay.
We got drama.
What's that? What's your problem?
Computer.
Where's Denny?
Is
it Denny left?
She wants to save
She has another thing open. That's what happened yesterday. Close your Word documents out.
So just say end. And then there you go.
I didn't know this was old. Okay, try it again
once. Click it one more time. Just say yes. Okay. I think part of the problem might be is the macro stopped running. Let's see what's here. Because the command is not available for reading. Just hit end. I'll tell you what. If you don't mind, what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue on. Can you guys share with each other? Would you mind doing that? Is that? And I'll come back to you after class if it's okay.
Okay.
Or the other option is close it, open it back up. Now, what you could do, I think, if you copy all the yellow cells there, just the yellow part, just do a control. Once you get them highlighted, control C, and then close it, open it back up again. Okay. Again, an issue had to do with a file open there. So let me know how that works, Brandy.
Okay. That's because you had a Word document?
Had a Word document open. Okay. And notice how it also puts the unit, the less than an activity number here, upper right-hand corner. So you got that. And we'll take a look at the worksheet document. You know, the worksheet document is basically a blank piece of paper. Okay. If you want... For your document, you can take this and rename. Let's say you've got a PDF file. Just take the name of the document and rename your PDF file and include it with your list. When you upload it, just upload it with that name on it.
How did you get to where you're at? Oh, wait, okay. Wait, do that again. Say you've got a
Okay, so.
Sheet saved. Open it up.
So I created that file right there.
Right.
Okay. But these guys over here, they've got PDF files that they want instead of that Word document. Okay. So what they're going to do, they're going to take that name right there.
Copy it.
I'm going to, if I single click this and hit a Control C, okay, now I can, I don't know if I've got any PDF files on here or not. I can go out and find my file and just rename it. Rename it.
Now, in renaming it, do I have to move it?
Put it in there. Now, this is probably not the most ideal place to work on your files. Okay. How many of you have thought about backing up your computer? Have you thought about that at all? How are you going to back it up? Tyler, how are you going to back your computer up?
You did a USB drive.
Okay. So you thought about it. You can put it on your Wiki. You can upload these to your Wiki. I want you to, that's a good way to do it. I want you to make sure that you back them up. But what I want you to do is I want you to move them out of the Unit Archive folder. Okay? So how do I do that?
As I'm working on it, move it out.
Okay. So there's the file I generated. If I just right click on that and click send to, just right click on that folder. Send to, and right here, I would put it in your documents folder. That's where I'd put it.
You did that on just that unit, right?
Just that folder is all I did it, okay?
You don't want to do that until you have how those forms really went pretty much created.
Until you're pretty sure this is what you're going to use and so on. I mean, you don't start backing stuff up until you've spent an hour on it, or well, I don't know. You have to use your own threshold. If I spent an hour on something, I don't want to lose it. I would back it up, okay. And I use a thumb drive. I mean, it's probably one way. I've got a couple external hard drives too. Now, so where did it put it? Well, it put it right here. It put it in this documents folder, and there it is, okay. Now, why would I put it in my documents folder? So we'll.
So if I lose the file, it was saved on my hard drive.
So if I right click.
I just didn't say it, right?
Send to, and then click on documents. I'm sorry. What was the question? Was there a question?
Or? No, you asked the question. You said, why should we save it in our documents?
Okay, and what was the answer?
I said, because if I lost that folder of yours or I messed that up, I'll put it on my hard drive.
Okay. Well, what I do when I back my computer up, I just copy that. I copy my documents folder and I just dump it onto my external hard drive.
What about to like going up to Google Docs with it?
You could do that as well.
Okay.
It's 15 gigabytes. These files aren't that big. I mean, they're probably in the order of kilobytes. So we've tried to keep those pretty small so that you don't fill up your Wiki. Okay. What I encourage you, don't put a lot of graphics and stuff inside the files. Okay?
So we can send it to, how do you send it to your Google Drive?
Well, in that particular case, what you'd want to do is to upload it to your Google Drive. Now, who can tell me how would I get that document onto Google Drive?
Open Google Drive, go to upload, find that file on your desktop inside that folder.
Should we demonstrate that? Okay, so I don't know. We're kind of straying from Andrew's guiding questions. So are you okay with that?
Yeah, you can play.
Okay, so I'm going to go over here. So I'm going to start a new tab, and I'm going to go to Drive. Okay, so there's my Google Drive. I got a bunch of stuff on there, but I think what you suggested is we would upload it. So we would upload it. Okay. Oh, okay, hold on. Let's go back.
That arrow next to create. Gotcha.
Right there. That arrow right there. Okay, I'm going to upload the folder. And it looks like it's pointing. Let's see, where is it pointing at?
It's on your desktop.
Actually, I got to go to, it's on library. It's under libraries. Well, okay, so what you're saying, I could go to my unit archive. That's right.
Go right to your archive.
So if I go to unit archive, Good suggestion.
Click on there, and there it is right there.
Okay. So I could do that, and I'm not going to do it because it'll tie the computer up. But that's an excellent question. Okay.
So wait a minute. What I hit send to.
Okay. Now send to is send to was to put it in your documents folder,
right,
on your computer.
So what we did then? What did we do? Send it to Google Drive.
You had to upload it. It's not sending to it. You're going to Google.
So do you have Google or Chrome open? Do you know how to get to your drive? Do you have a Google Drive?
Yeah.
Okay. So.
It's open.
Okay. So basically, what you want to do is click on that upload. So do you have a screen that looks like this?
It's my G Drive. Yes.
Okay. So what I want to do is I want to click on upload.
Yeah.
And then click on folder.
Oh, okay. Restart
it. And then you want to go find it. Okay. And what we did is we looked on the desktop, and
I upload the entire unit archive.
Well, you probably don't want to do that because there's probably multiple copies. What you want to do is you pick out the specific folder that you want to upload,
which is your most recent folder, because you're going to have a bunch of folders for each.
Right, exactly. And you're going to have to manage that. You're going to have to decide what what files to upload and so on.
So when I'm typing,
okay, so we've had some good suggestions here. Put it on a thumb drive, put it on an external hard drive. I put it in my documents folder because all I have to do when I back my computer up is anything in that documents folder, I just copy to my hard drive, or to my external hard drive, okay? Because I've got a lot of other stuff in there as well, and I'm sure you will. So I would always encourage you to store your stuff in the documents folder. Okay, now let's go back to these questions here. So let me ask, what questions have we answered? So, where's the first place to go? Do you know where to go?
2014
Okay. So, how can I generate my unit files? Have we answered that? Okay. What does generate my files mean?
Putting the title.
Create blank ones.
Was it create blank ones? Yeah. There's still a lot of work to do, right? Okay. And it saves those. Once I open Excel, what do I have to put in? Are you okay with that one? Okay. Once files are generated, what do I have to do? Okay, and I think that had to do with backing it up. Maybe is that okay? Or filling them in. You need to work on filling them in. Okay, where's the unit file generator?
On
a desktop in templates 2014.
Forgot 6.
Oh, 6. Okay. What if I forgot how to do it? Where is the tutorial? Where is the tutorial? So on the CEEMS website, left-hand column, unit file generator, there's 4 videos, okay?
If you,
I don't know. I don't know if I saw the email.
What 4 videos did we get yesterday?
The one that's on the left-hand side.
They're
on the
Wiki
thing.
From the CEEMS?
Yeah.
I didn't get an email for it. I just
we got an invite.
Has everybody gotten access to this site here? Okay, so right there, unit file generator.
I goofed that up. Okay.
Okay, so again, the ones you want to watch first are the getting started. All that does is shows you how to set your computer up and how to toggle back and forth between files. Now, the naming standard explains
the numbers
and so on. Okay? You're welcome to look at that one. That's probably not the most critical. Before next week, Thursday, I would advise you to look at the third one here, revising your unit file set. Okay? So this, I'll give you a week to do, it's over a week to do this homework here. Okay. Now, what that does is it's going to tell you, again, how to insert files and so on. You can actually take PDF files and you throw all the files. There's a folder on your desktop. And since you ran the unit file generator, there's another folder on your desktop called Rename Files. You probably didn't notice that at all. But the unit file generator created that.
If you dump all of your files into there, you load them back into the unit file generator, and then you start adjusting the A's, the B's, the C's, and so on, resort it, and then what it does is it makes copies of those files and it renames them. Okay? So that's how you can get them sorted in a different order and so on.
Well, I'm typing in the file generator. Will it be simultaneous? It's not simultaneously saving into my Google Drive.
Correct.
So how do I have to upload it again?
So when you create the files, when you hit that create button on the unit file generator, the only thing it does is it puts them into the unit archive on your desktop.
Right. So I save my unit archive.
That's just a folder.
Right. I saved it into my Google Drive to back it up.
Correct.
So when I want to back it up again,
got to do the same thing. It's not synchronized at all. I mean, you can buy online backup services that will back up your hard drive, but I wouldn't spend money to do that for this.
Why is the Google Drive running if you adjust it? It will match all of those on every computer that you are doing it.
Oh, I see. Stuff. Okay. When I talk about Google Drive, I mean, I've downloaded their app, so you can see actually Google. I don't have it. This is not my computer, so I don't have it set up that way. But you can actually set it up so you can just drag that folder into your Google Drive, right? I mean.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so then while I'm working within the generate files, when I pull up the document to edit it, it's automatically saving it. When I go to my unit template.
So if you go to
my unit template,
if you go to the unit archive, open up that folder, mm-hmm. and you open up this document. Mm-hmm. So let's do that. I think I know where you're headed here.
So it's automatically saving it.
Well, but where is it saving it? So if I go to my unit archive, uh-huh. I go to the folder I just created, I open up the unit plan. Uh-huh. Okay, and so I write something in here. Uh-huh. Okay, so say I write the word math in here. Okay, and I save it. What does that do with it?
It saves it
back in the unit archive folder, in that folder that it was in. It's just a folder, okay? When you get it in that folder, at this point in time, all of the unit management, the folder management, all that Microsoft stuff kind of takes over. You do that just like you do any other file, okay? The unit file generator is just to get that naming standard correct and help you manage those files to get started. One of the things that's going to happen this summer is you'll use that unit file generator this summer, and you probably won't see it again until next year. Okay? So because there's no need. Once you generate your files and get them fine-tuned.
And then you'll fine-tune these pieces right here.
Right. Yep. So. Okay. So, did I answer this question here?
Desktop.
Should we save? It says, where should we save these files while we are editing them?
Desktop and then back.
Where would you put them while you're editing? Do you want to leave them in that unit archive folder? You could. Make sure you back them up though.
Put them under documents.
I would put them under documents. Okay. Now, can we mess up the program, Brandy? I'm going to ask you. Can you brush this up? Okay. And what are some things that you can, how can we mess it up?
She doesn't know what she did, but okay. Her computer is jacked.
I'll have to take a look at it. Maybe there's some easy solution. I don't know. The problems you'll run into are things like you put a semicolon or you put in an illegal character in one of the wrong columns. Something's open that shouldn't be and so on. So it can be. Does everybody have my email address? If you don't have my email address, I would suggest that you take it down. Now, if I could spell. Actually, I think the spelling checker got me here.
Are we done?
Well, we answered the question. I think we answered all the questions. Are we done? Andrew, are we done?
Yes, sir.
It's good enough for me. Next Thursday, we're going to do this again, okay? And so write down the questions you have between now and Thursday, or I wrote down my email, okay? Send me an email if you got a question, and I'll try to help you. If it turns out it's a real big issue, I can get online with you. I've got a program called GoToMeeting. We can do an online session if it gets to that point. So
our units are due Thursday.
What's that?
Our units are due Thursday.
You've got a unit that's due Thursday. Between now and then, there it is, okay?
So my other question is this week or next week?
Next week, next Thursday, July 3rd.
How can I add you in my Google so that I don't have to keep retyping your email, you know, contacts that's on Google?
Oh, so you want to go put it in Google Contacts?
Yes, how would it look?
Do you know how to, do you have your contacts set up in?
No, I don't even know how to do that.
Oh, okay, maybe everybody else is interested, so let me. Okay. You're welcome, Andrew. I got you, Brandy. You're next here.
Miss Ma'am, am I all good?
Yes, you are all good.
Thank you.
I will see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, so do you have your Gmail up?
I've got my Gmail up.
Okay, so right here where it says it's got the Gmail drop down here. Click on Contacts. Okay, and when you get to contacts, just click on New Contact. Okay, so put Jack Broering in the where it says Add Name. Just start typing. Broering. Yeah, there you go. And then down here where it says Email, click in that box and just type jack.broering@gmail.com.
Can you go to that next page where your email was already up for us?
Oh, okay, sorry, yep.
No, you're perfect.
Okay,
okay. You can automatically hold your picture up.
Uh-huh.
See, that's consultant, Rory. You guys are in my cell phone. You keep hopping in.
Okay, very good.
Yep, you're right there.
I teach computer classes, and I teach senior citizens how to do this, and you guys are a little quicker than the senior citizens are, but I do love the senior citizens because they never argue with me.
They think you're a